FEMA is always ready to respond to these emergencies by pre-staging.
And they're doing a brilliant job, by the way. I want to point that out.
Pre-staging, training of state and local personnel to respond and recover faster. One of the things that I believe we need all to improve in, especially at the local and state level, is once again that communication with the public. A community that is informed recovers faster. That is a true statement, and we all need to recognize and understand that. So on a blue sky, sunny day, we can use all of our smart technologies, smart speaker systems, the internet, and all of those things that work well and we have embraced so well in our culture. After a disaster, a lot of those things don't work very well, but we still need to communicate with the community and those survivors. And that's why we run the programs that we run. That's why we offer the thoughts and the actions of resilience, right, of readiness, power resiliency, communications resiliency, human resiliency. Folks can't work if they're taking care of their families, if they are survivors themselves and are terribly affected by emergencies. So you've got to be able to bring in surge components into a disaster area or have additional local human resources in those areas. Better partnerships and pre-agreements with other government agencies and private sector partners so that you're ready to react, you're ready to respond to any of these emergencies, mutual aid packs. One of the things that we offer as strong suggestions, testing and exercises. Folks at the state and local levels often don't do enough of that. That includes communications. Just because it works today doesn't mean it'll work tomorrow. Doesn't mean it will work under the conditions that you are now facing in an emergency. When I talk about power resiliency, I always preach a bit about fuel, servicing those generators, making sure that things continue to operate. If you have no power, you are out of business.